So, given the fact that captive power needs to be mainstreamed for maybe, purposes of handling the peaking load, and maybe captive power in the long run can also be used for base load, who knows?
No, captive power, concept of captive power was introduced when we could not meet the industrial demand. We asked industry, you please set up your own plant and you meet your demand. That is how the captive came. Now those captive, because of there is a spare capacity or maybe idle capacity and there is a power shortage. So we are asking those captive to please generate and meet the demand. So the role of captive are different, but now since the rates are going very high, like 10 rupees, 9 rupees and so on and so forth, they can also make much money out of it. And at the same time, we need it for national development.
Sir, given the fact that captive power producers, or sorry, these industries were allowed to set up their own captive power plants, this now means they have got about 10 to 20 years of experience of actually generating power, to some extent even setting up small, low distance distribution lines also, transmission lines to very small distances. So this means that a pool has been created where we can further develop the power sector. The private sector themselves know how to do the power sector, unlike, say, the nuclear power sector, where it was completely government controlled for strategic reasons. So we have a pool over there. So can we utilize this pool to, further develop IPPs, MPPs, and hydel projects?
Power generation is a very, very well-developed industry. We have lot many experts. We have 150,000 megawatt of installed capacity, and there is a large pool of talented engineers. There is no dearth of people who can develop it. So far, captive power stations are concerned, as I earlier said, these were required to meet certain demand. And the capacity is not very high, maybe 50 megawatt, 60 megawatt, 100 megawatt, something. So any small capacity is inherently per megawatt quite expensive.
Right.
So that is why now we are going in for ultra mega projects and very, say, 800 megawatt rating units and so on to bring down the tariff.
So if there is so much of manpower available, so much of expertise available, generation capacity is rising, but transmission capacities are still under the government control. Private investments of transmission have not been not really fructified to the extent that they have in generation. So why is transmission still choked?
No, gentlemen, transmission capacity, first of all, let me remind you about the entire power sector. Power sector means 1 acre per megawatt. If you set up a thermal plant, the population of the country is so high, and in some states the density is so high, like West Bengal and Bihar, that if we have to set up a 1,000 megawatt thermal project, we minimum need 1,000 to 1,200 acre of land, which is just not available. Now, to transmit this power, we need corridors. Already, there are so many 400 kV lines and now 765 kV, 800 kV DC and so on, that we cannot allow everyone to construct it. We need corridors where the minimum land utilization is, so to say, best
Maximized. We have
maximized.
to derive the best out
Yeah,
of that
we
land.
have to derive benefits out of that. So that is why we are creating certain corridors in which even private are being asked to participate. There is a one line coming from Mundra to Haryana, Hisar.
Which is a private.
Yeah, it is under private. Similarly, Reliance has got. The certain corridors have been created, but then there are no other problems like pooling of the power from various. Then they have to, each one of them has to contribute. And to avoid all those problems, there is a CTU like Power Grid. It is authorized to construct those, and it is a common pool, it is a common resource which can be utilized by others.